We got to move on. We have the awesome Cyborg versus James Zickick.
Rush will be on Judgment Day. 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 When you're looking for another side, you in the zone, so it's time to brutalize, hypnotize. Don't make a feeling paralyzed. Bang him with an uppercut, bang him on the inside, pulverize.
I don't know much about James. I know that he's been away for like 3 years without fighting, but I'm very well prepared and I hope he's prepared as well.
I know Cyborg. He's very aggressive. He's an animal. He'll come at me flying out the blocks. I'll be ready for him. I'll counter punch him. I'll take him down. I'll do whatever it takes to win.
Well, my best strategy is standing up, so that's what I'm going to do tonight.
I'll be relying on everything. Stand up, jiu-jitsu, boxing, Muay Thai, wrestling, everything. I'll bring it all to the table. I'm ready in every area.
I'm going to give him such a beating that's going to be another 2 years that James wants to fight again.
I haven't fought for 2 years inside the cage, but life is a fight, and I've been fighting all my life. It's second nature. I'm ready for him, and I'm going to take him out.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is for the vacant Cage Rage Light Heavyweight Championship of the World. First to enter the Cage Rage Octagon, weighing in at 92.6 kilograms, he's representing Shooterbox. He has a background in Muay Thai and a Cage Rage record of 2-2. From Brazil, please welcome Evangelista Cyborg weighing in at 91.5 kilograms. He's representing London Shoot Fighters. He has a background in mixed martial arts and a Cage Rage record of 1-0. From England, please welcome James the Messenger Zickick!
Ladies and gentlemen,
We are scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds of action for the Cage Rage Light Heavyweight Championship of the World. With my left, Evangelista Silo Santa. And on my right, James the Messenger Zicky. And the referee in charge of the action is Mr. Grant Waterman.
In a light heavyweight title fight decider.
Well, that's a lot of pressure, especially pressure in that he's facing a 29-year-old in Cyborg who is entering into his 10th year as a pro MMA fighter.
When I say stop, you stop. Touch gloves, get ready for war. All the way back. All the way back, guys.
Guys, I've got to be honest. I'm expecting fireworks all over again.
I am seeing the height advantage going to James, and that would lead me to believe that Cyborg might want to take this fight to the ground.
What about the perspective of cage rust? For James, it's a big fight to come back to after coming out of retirement.
It is, but as Rob said earlier, he's been training hard almost as if he's been fighting, so sometimes that rust factor can be a minimum, especially after you get past that first round.
He's also very deceptive, Rob James Zicic. He's a very cool fighter, emotionless most of the time, but he does the business.
Well, that's right. We know with Cyborg that over the last couple of outings that Cyborg's had, he's got a lot more tactical in his striking as he goes to try to pick James Zicic apart. James takes one big shot.
James is far too defensive right now. He's just sitting there waiting to block punches, and as a result, he was getting hit.
He specifically ate a big right hand in that exchange.
Watch out for the knee here. Cyborg had that plum clinch. James has got to wake up, and he's got to hurt Cyborg to get Cyborg moving back, or at least to stop moving forward. The low kicks have been a big factor for Cyborg to set up the punch combinations.
And again, as you said that, James got caught on the counter. You've got to set that up.
Cyborg has really improved his boxing since the first couple times we saw him at Cage Rage, where he used to just swing from way back from his hips. Now he boxes a little more correct and returns his hand to his chin to avoid the counterpunch.
He also has very good head movement. If you watch Cyborg as he steps side to side, his head movement is very good, making it a hard target for James Zicic to focus in on.
And he's going to need that head movement because Zicic has got that reach advantage.
Look at the legs of Zicic already, marked up both legs from those low kicks, and they will take their toll.
And what Cyborg is going to do, and it was a beautiful left hook counter there by Cyborg. Cyborg is going to chop away at those legs and wait till James drops his hand, trying to catch the leg, and then Cyborg is going to try and drop a bomb with a punch.
I've got to be honest, guys, I'm very impressed with Cyborg. He's back James Zicic up against the cage, a big right hand followed by a combination of shots to the body and the head.
Cyborg should concentrate on the body attack when he covers up like that to the head.
Great work by Cyborg.
But if we put it in perspective, it can be great when you're not getting anything coming back. At the moment, James is so tentative that, no disrespect to Cyborg, it's been a good performance, but what does he have to fight against at the moment?
You're absolutely right, but it doesn't matter because Cyborg is doing his job. At the moment, James is not doing his, and he's just sitting there getting punched and kicked. You've got to offer resistance in the form of a counterattack.
This is not the James Zicic I remember, Rob.
No, definitely not, mate.
It's not going to be too many more of those low kicks by Cyborg, and James will have a problem standing on that front left leg. And if that happens, he'll either have to switch to southpaw or go to the floor.
Well, that's what's quite surprising for me. I know from seeing James in previous experiences, he has fantastic leg kicks of his own and is very well balanced. He just looks slightly off balance, and those leg kicks are really taking their toll.
When I saw him fight Gary Turner, who, as we know, is no mug and top billing tonight, It was an absolute war, and he matched him kick for kick, punch for punch. And yet here, he's just soaked it up.
Yeah, he has. Cyborg has to be careful to conserve his energy, and he is. He's picking his shots, leading with the left inside kick, the right outside kick, and countering with hooks.
Yes, the inside and the outside of James Sikic's left thigh, best testament to that, Steve.
I think Sikic would be wise to start checking and using his left jab. Checking the kick, meaning blocking the low kick by Cyborg.
Do you think this could be ring rust for James Sikic?
Well, we talked about it. It looks like it to me, Steve.
It is ring rust, and it's one of those things where you got to jump into as if you didn't have ring rust. It's a mental thing. It's really hard to overcome because the experience in fighting is that if you fight a lot, you've got an advantage over someone who does not fight a lot, even if they were a great fighter at one time. Cyborg picking his shots now, and wisely so, almost got hit with an overhand right there by Sikic. Cyborg starting to drop his hands. He's got to be careful. Cyborg is reverting back to some old habits. He's got to keep his hands up because the man with the reach, which is James, could throw a straight right down the pike and hurt him.
Well, picking up on your last point, one of the things he has started doing is just started to sneak out that jab.
Yeah.
Well, this is one of the other things, guys. We know we've seen Cyborg fight full pace for a couple of rounds. Do you think it could be a pace factor?
Absolutely, Rob.
Sky Movies has changed to help you find your film. Now there's a channel for comedy movies, for drama, family films, for classics, for action thrillers. You get the picture. With 10 channels devoted to your every movie need, including one just for premieres, plus two extra channels in high definition, you can stop searching and start finding. Sky Movies, your guiding light to great film.
Okay, welcome back to Wembley Arena for Cage Rage 21 Judgment Day. We've seen a great first round for Cyborg, who delivered that overhand left, followed by the overhand right, and had James Sikic backing up.
And so far at the moment, we have the results of a Pro Elite poll, ProElite.com poll results, and they actually have 70% choosing Cyborg to win, with 58% saying it will finish it with a KO or by a TKO.
Well, Cyborg owned that first round, in my opinion, and he's got to be careful to conserve the energy because James took everything that the Brazilian offered but never went down. As a matter of fact, this fight ended up looking more like a kickboxing match than an MMA fight.
Do you think James will play it out against Cyborg's cardio? I mean, would that be a smart thing to do right now, Steve?
Well, that would be the Rocky Balboa thing to do for sure. It's not the wisest game plan, but it is a situation that could happen in this fight. Cyborg has to be aware of that because James is coming on strong with low kicks.
And with the physique of James Sikic, you'd expect it to carry the cardio a little bit better, wouldn't you? Because of the oxygen obviously feeding Cyborg's muscles with the amount of shots that he's throwing as well.
And James has to get into second gear because that first round was a Cyborg round. James has to steal this one back, and he's got to do it by being aggressive.
Timing was good there, Steve, with that kick. Called Cyborg to smile there.
Yeah, but because he didn't sweep him. That was an attempted sweep low kick.
See, one of you guys made it clear in the first round that, you know, sometimes it just takes that first round to brush the cobwebs off. I think that's what we're starting to see as Sikic starts to put himself back into it.
Yeah, Sikic is a lot more aggressive here, and he's starting to become accurate with that right hand. That's the weapon that Cyborg has to be aware of here.
Now, when you talk of a wake-up call, that left leg is a wake-up call.
Wow, you can see the bruising on the side of that left leg. Inside and outside, I might add, guys.
Checks for the first time possibly in the fight. Oh, and a nice uppercut as well.
Sikic is moving forward now. This is the opposite of Sikic in the first round.
Do you know what, guys? I think the first round may have been strategy, a little bit of blowing off the cobwebs and a little bit of strategy, because now he's looking to come alive. His shots are accurate. He's throwing them at different angles, and they're landing beautifully.
This is not good for Cyborg, and the crowd knows it. The crowd is behind the hometown boy here at Wembley Arena.
Steve, I want to pick up on a simple but important thing that you mentioned. He's always coming forward now. He is happy to stay in Cyborg's range. There's a new confidence about him, and as you said, a new attitude about his work. He's the one subtly changing this now.
He is, and I think he tuned into the fact that the cardio that Cyborg expended in that first round may be coming back to haunt him, at least momentarily, although second wind is a factor for any fighter, including Evangelista Santos, also known as Cyborg.
James is looking very sharp out there as he starts to box. He really is calling on his boxing skills at the moment, guys, looking very sharp and accurate.
I think part of the reason why Zicic has jumped into second gear here is an emotional thing. I think he probably got angry at himself after that first round performance and through the coaching of Alexis from London Shoot Fighters came out and said, hell no, you ain't gonna beat me, not here, not now, and he's gonna give it his all here in the second.
Cyborg looks like he's breathing very heavy now, or starting to breathe very heavy from the stomach.
And again, James is subtly working downstairs as well, up and down. He looks a different fighter. He is a very skilled boxer, and he's showing it in this round.
What it is that Cyborg is definitely going after that leg, but James is still standing there.
And you can hear the crowd's response. That doesn't need us to tell you anything, does it?
No, the crowd can commentate every time one of those bombs lands by James.
I tell you what, guys, it's certainly been a stand-up war. Hasn't been to the ground once yet. These two guys trading some big shots.
We came to Wembley Arena on April 21st expecting a mixed martial art fight, and a kickboxing match broke out.
And it really has. The heat has turned up slowly but surely in this one.
This has definitely been James's round, but he's got to be careful because Cyborg was starting to get dangerous in the last 30 seconds.
Yes. For me, this is the sensible fight for James. You know, he's just taking his time now, looking to pick those shots, working his way in and then working his way straight back out again. For me, this is the right fight for him to be fighting.
It's a range thing at the moment. James has found his range, and Cyborg's just slightly out with those punches.
If James still had enough juice to stand on that left leg and deliver a right high kick, that would be a good weapon to use right now, because Cyborg is dropping his left hand.
And again, I like the way James is working to the body as well. Superb finish here from James Zicic.
Works in for the clinch with a beautiful big knee.
What a finish to the round. Superb.
That was a reaction by the crowd that surely sent a chill down the spines of both these athletes. One from Cyborg, who knows now he's fighting not only James Zicic, but also the entire stadium here, and also to James Zicic to really represent. And here we are, Zicic going with the uppercut and the hook and the body shot. He really had the combinations in the second round.
Do you know what's happened here? The audience have gained confidence in a man who's gained confidence in himself.
Absolutely.
Beautiful work by James. You can see more accurate. He's looking to pick the shots.
He's really boxing well because he's shielding, he's using his shoulders to block punches, and Cyborg is not throwing the low kick as much because kicking takes a lot more energy than punching. And Cyborg threw so many kicks at the leg, but James is still here.
And he's very much in this fight. He's very, very accurate as well, Rob. I think this could be the third round to die for.
If he keeps working with those combinations, you know, he's working up, he's working down, I think he could actually bag this one, guys.
Whoever wins this round wins the fight, in my opinion.
And the light heavyweight Cage Rage world title.
There's the leg check defense by James Zicic. Cyborg, it's obvious that the instructions from his corner from Shootbox was to go back to the low kick.
Good left hook from James. And a different pattern now, Rob. It's James doing the stalking and Cyborg that's backing off.
Cyborg has a very good counter left hook off the straight right. But it's a dangerous thing because when a guy throws a straight right from that far away with that kind of a reach advantage that James has, it may hit you. So to try and counter it with your shorter arm over the top is dangerous unless you put your left shoulder into the counter to block the right hand.
Do you know what, guys? I'm surprised James Zikic can even keep moving. That left leg of his has some really big welts. Zikic shooting for the takedown.
And Cyborg sprawling and stuffing the takedown. Finally, they get into an over-under clinch.
The only reason I can think for that takedown attempt is the leg. He's doing so well upright at the moment and so dominant that it's got to be that leg, finally. There's no other reason because he's doing well upright here, as you can see, right above our commentary position now.
Some great combinations of shots.
That left leg of James Zikic looks nasty.
It looks like raw meat from here, red both sides. But Rob, he's winning this upright war.
He is, he's starting to, he's worked his way back into it since the second round and he's just continuing to pick away at Cyborg up there, upstairs and downstairs. Great work by James Zikic.
Zikic is showing an incredible amount of heart here in this third and final round of this contest.
And he catches Cyborg with a left and a short right.
Guys, I've got to be honest, I think Cyborg's in trouble. His cardio just doesn't seem to be able to carry him through the three rounds. He looks like he's breathing really, really heavy now.
And again, Zikic is stalking.
Zikic does seem to be the better in the cardiovascular department at the moment, but he is slowing down too.
Oh, and another sickening leg kick there from Cyborg.
Cyborg's hands are dropping really low now with the advantage that James has in reach. He needs to be very careful. He needs to keep those hands up.
There's the right hand and it lands clean. Stops Cyborg in his tracks for a second there. But we talk about the durability of Zikic. Let's not forget Cyborg here.
Yeah, Cyborg has taken some shots, like that uppercut.
We now have two very tired men with under 2 minutes of this round left. It's still there, I believe, for the taking.
It really is. I think James is winning this round right now, but with 1 minute 40 seconds left, Cyborg could stage a comeback.
What a great third round, guys.
Good overhand right from Zikic as well. Finishing strongly.
Zikic is starting to reach, though. I find it interesting that Zikic never tried a high kick against Cyborg.
Maybe, as you said, it's a balanced thing with that left leg. He's taken so much, but and still continues to take punishment to it.
Some good shots again, a good combination.
James Zikic has a huge threshold for pain, especially on that front left leg of his.
There's the right hand. I'd like to see him come downstairs with the follow-up there. We are coming to the close of this fight, and it's just the tension has cranked up each round, hasn't it?
It really has, and I think that they've got whoever's going to win this round is going to have to crank it up, as you say, in this final 25 seconds of the match. Somebody should go for broke right here, because it's really close. I would say that James is winning this round, but you never know. You can't leave it to the judges. You've got to accelerate.
Rob, 10 seconds left, your thoughts?
I think Zikic has done enough for me to win it. He's the more accurate, he's the one pushing the pace. For me, from the second round, he really has chased this fight.
Well, that's it, and what a great fight. Grant Waterman there acknowledging that. And I agree with Rob, Steve, I think Zikic has stolen this.
I agree also, because Zikic had all the answers in round number two, and even though that third round was close, Zikic landed the cleaner shots. Cyborg didn't have much to offer other than some low kicks. It looks like James Zikic will now be the Cage Rage champion, but we are not judges.
Exactly, no. But that crowd, I feel, think the same way. I think there's a bit of hometown bias here.
Well, that's okay, because it happens wherever you go. You go to Thailand, they got a bias. You go to any country, they have a bias. We shall see soon what the judges think in this great three-round fight. Look at the counter shots by Zickich in this final round, and he caught Cyborg with a good left hook to the jaw, and Cyborg took it. So both men showed a tremendous amount of heart here in the final stanza.
That's what really impressed me, is the fact that he just strung those combinations together.
Well, it's going to be tense, but here goes Mark.
Ladies and gentlemen, the trophies will be presented by Chief Executive Officer from Elite XC from Los Angeles, Doug DeLuca. After 15 minutes of light heavyweight championship action, we go to the judges' scorecards and we have a winner by majority decision in favor of your new Cage Rage Light Heavyweight Champion of the World, James the Messenger
what makes Cage Rage so good. Two guys going toe-to-toe. And James, how does it feel to be the new world champion?
Well, first of all, it's someone I'd like to thank. The greatest warrior that ever lives. The greatest, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, Jesus Christ. I get all my strength from the Lord. God is real. God is real, mate.
I take it, talk about real. Have a look at this leg. I mean, is that hurting you at the moment?
I don't feel a thing. My mind was in his arm. I'm a machine.
You were everything that he threw at you in that first round. Was that tactics? Were you trying to wear him down?
A little bit, about 50-50. I was trying to take the sting out of him a little bit, box him, move around him, and I used some tactics on him and wear him out.
Well, tell you what, come on, London, put your hands together for this man, your new world champion, Andy and Dave.
We have ourselves a champion, James Zickich. Now, I've just got a very, very quick story to tell. Melvin Manhoff, of course, had to relinquish his belt because, he couldn't defend it anymore due to K1 contracts. K1 are going to allow him to come back and fight. We may have a comeback from Melvin versus James Zickich.
I've got more news for you, Andy. I'm talking to Vita Belfort out here. If he wins tonight, he wants a challenge for that belt straight away.
Oh, my God.
It's unbelievable.
There's so much more action to come. Do not go anywhere. We have got to take a very, very short commercial break.